And God did extraordinary miracles by the hands of Paul, so that handkerchiefs or aprons were carried away from his body to the sick, and diseases left them, and the evil spirits came out of them. Then some of the itinerant Jewish exorcists undertook to pronounce the name of the Lord Jesus over those who had evil spirits, saying, "I adjure you by Jesus, whom Paul preaches." Seven sons of a Jewish high priest named Sceva were doing this.
I put a spell on you. Cause you're mine. Do, 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 do. You better stop the things you do.
Okay, so today in the narrative of the Acts of the Apostles, we run into some miraculous supernatural things. So first of all, the reading starts off with the holy napkins, is they're called. So people were going to see Paul, and they were taking napkins or washcloths or sweat cloths, I guess is the most literal translation of that, and they were taking them home to people who were sick, people who were dying, people who were unwell, and saying a prayer and putting the cloth on them was causing them to be healed. So that's the first part of the story. Then you run into the sons of Sceva, the seven sons of Sceva. Now, the sons of Sceva were itinerant Jewish exorcists. And so they would go from town to town, casting out demons from people, from houses, from this, from that. And so they made their living by casting out demons. And we have a little insight into all this with Sceva himself. If you were to do a study, an inquiry into Jewish high priests, they are recorded very fastidiously, dutifully, and the name Sceva is nowhere to be found in the annals of the Jewish high priests. So he's not on record in Jerusalem as being one of the high priests. And if you look at the actual use of his name, if you look at the Latin of that, it's left-handed, or a derivative of left-handed. And we, if you haven't known this, it's a lot of facts for one morning. But if you don't know this, left-handed is where the word sinister comes from. So left-handed was for the longest time seen as a defect, seen as less than honest. In fact, left-handed people up until Middle Ages, late Middle Ages, could not be priests or ministers. There were a lot of things left-handed people were excluded from. I'm left-handed myself, so I don't, I'm not judging left-handed people, but saying that Sceva's name leads one to believe, and the lack of record of Sceva leads us to believe that he himself was an itinerant Jewish exorcist, high priest, and then with him having that name was a sort of a scam artist. So these people were going from town to town, exorcising demons and things like that, taking people's money and going home. It is of note that no one pays for the holy napkins that comes from Paul. And if that's kind of weird to you, the idea of napkins that touched Paul healing people, I will point you to the lady with the issue of blood that touches the hem of the garment of our Lord and receives healing. So it's not unprecedented for the modern ear, maybe unusual, but not unprecedented. And it's important to know that money was not exchanged for those or anything like that. That I think it comes from an honest place of holiness and prayer and an extension of God using Paul for healing and evangelization and things like that. The sons of Sceva and Sceva himself, that's another thing altogether entirely. The sons of Sceva find out about the holy napkins, and in wishing to capitalize on that, they change their practice and they begin to do battle with demonic forces and imploring and saying the name of Paul, the God of Paul, Jesus, I cast you out in those names. And an interesting thing happens to them. They are overtaken by the demons. They are overcome. They are beaten, bloodied, wounded, and stripped of all their clothing and kicked out of the house. So it's one thing when they are sort of, and I'm, you know, just objectively the case, I don't know. there's not tremendous amounts of firsthand evidence, but I understand them to have been sort of, you know, messing around and taking advantage of people and doing left-handed or sinister kind of things and not knowing what they're really getting into. And then when they went into a situation and called on the name of Jesus, or called on the name of Paul, the God of Paul, this Jesus, and did that, they stepped in to a battlefield that they had no idea was there. So instead of just sort of fooling around, messing with people, taking advantage of people, they stepped squarely into the spiritual realm, unprepared, and got their hats handed to them, as it were. I say this because anyone who steps into the spiritual realm, or anyone, if you look at the history of exorcisms or things like that, it's done through faith. It is not done by any strength, power, prowess of the exorcist, but things like that have to be done with the greatest amount of faith in Jesus. And love for Jesus. So if you go in the exorcism business and aren't a person of deep, abiding faith, you'll end up like the sons of Sceva with your hat handed to you naked. You know, send them away ashamed in their nakedness, which, you know, is sort of metaphorical for, you know, the fullness of their brokenness. Or naked before God means there's nothing left to hide from them, that they were indeed sinister hucksters taking advantage of them. Now what I want to think about today is that idea of the spiritual realm, that idea of good and evil living all around us, that idea of there being angels in a spiritual realm that coexists with the material and physical. How do we navigate that? When we get into dark places, when dark things come upon us, when we enter into the darkness, the only antidote for that is faith and love for Jesus. And with that, you can do battle with demons. Nobody gonna do that. That's a very specialized thing. But you'll have darkness in your life. You'll have dark spiritual things in your life, and the defense against them is love and faith in Jesus, and it is Jesus who does battle with them. So contemplate that, and also from time to time I do a segment with our youth group that's called Stump the Priest, and almost every time, unfailingly, there's a question about Ouija boards and things like that. Are they bad? Are they evil? Everybody here is watching this as an adult, but I would say, you know, when you start entering into those realms and start pushing the boundaries of things, spiritual things, and pushing it, you're getting in over your head, just like the sons of Sceva when they started going deeper into that and going from just being hucksters or shysters to using the name of Jesus without faith or love. They got into more than they bargained for, and we can too. So it's important to be to know that darkness and evil are overcome by Jesus, not us, and that through faith and love in Jesus, we can walk through those dark things. Those dark things don't overcome us. We won't get wounded and thrown out of the house naked if we use our love and our faith in Jesus to guide our way. Not Ouija boards or not sinister or left-handed dealings with other people or with the spiritual realm. So say your prayers, love Jesus, love one another, and have a good Thursday. God bless you all. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.